The University of Massachusetts Lowell, through a newly established research center based on strategic corporate partnerships, is advancing the state of the art in printed electronics design, fabrication, and characterization technologies.
What's unique about this facility is that on one floor, we have everything we need to create rapid prototypes of electronic systems and devices. We have a full complement of advanced design and simulation tools. We have a large variety of different types of printing technology and the ability to test and characterize. Test the devices and subsystems we make, as well as characterize the new materials that we make. So everything we need is on this floor. The students are trained to do every aspect of that.
I designed the strip lines in HFSS on Monday. I drew up the CAD designs later that evening, and by Tuesday I was printing my designs, curing it, and Wednesday I was making measurements.
They do design, they do fabrication or printing, they do testing.
I have been leading the effort in characterization of electromagnetic properties of the substrate. I have been working in this interdisciplinary team for printed electronics for the last 2 years.
And so we're really capable of creating very rapid prototypes in days without having to farm out some of the work.
It's fast here because everything you need is on the same floor. You can have one person work on a single design instead of trying to work in between different companies, different groups within a company. And sometimes a lot of that can slow down the fabrication process.
Being on a university campus, we are able to tap into the resources and expertise across the campus. We have a plastics engineering department here, for instance. Our substrates are often plastic, and it's very helpful to have the polymer scientists and the plastics engineering available to us.
This close relationship with the plastics engineering department faculty has led to a federal grant that is for almost $2 million for developing the next generation of flexible substrates for printed electronics with properties that are tailor-made for our needs.
So being on campus gives us access to a wide variety of expertise that you wouldn't find resonant in a company.
What kind of dielectric constant?
We are doing our research in an environment where we have a corporate partner.
Raytheon and UMass Lowell established RURI so that we could advance our capabilities for rapid prototyping and printed electronics.
The Raytheon UMass Lowell Research Institute was formed in partnership with Raytheon, where Raytheon engineers and scientists are co-located with us here on this campus and work very closely with faculty, staff, and students.
One great thing about my internship this past summer is I was able to work with some Raytheon employees and get their expertise.
By working with RURI and the students here, we are growing that pipeline by giving the students exposure to the new technologies and capabilities that Raytheon is ultimately going to need.
Because my project is a Raytheon-funded IRAD project, I was able to go to their facility and work with some people who had more familiarity with this area.
Companies like Raytheon are a system integrator. They don't make printing equipment, they don't make materials. We're working with PERC to expand our corporate relationships and partnerships with companies that do make equipment, do make ink.
It's a good partnering opportunity. We get access to equipment and research that as a small business we don't get access to ourselves. And so that helps keep us knowledgeable of what's out there and coming down the pike in terms of new technology. We've hired a number of co-op students through the years and actually brought several of those on as full-time employees.
PERC was started to expand our corporate footprint to more companies, to build out the supply chain or the ecosystem for printed electronics.
With PERC, Raytheon and other companies get the benefit of working at UMass Lowell in a pre-competitive space where we can all work together to help develop the supply chain and capabilities for printed RF electronics.
In a nutshell, PERC provides leverage for a lot of companies to expand their capabilities. So in a sense, we are building the ecosystem in printed electronics.
We've partnered with PERC on several projects with federal government, Department of Defense work with the Office of Naval Research on printing of a phased array.
We have a large number of federally funded projects with our PERC partners that allow them to compete in this area, even though they don't have all of the capabilities internally.
One of our most successful projects to date was a result of Raytheon's need for a fully printed, tunable, flexible electromagnetic filter or a frequency selective surface. We developed a brand new ferroelectric ink which allowed us to attain the tunability by integrating it into a fully printable varactor. This ferroelectric ink has led to several awards, including one from ID TechX for R&D, as well as another R&D award from FlexTech.
One of the inks that we...
Potential students should consider this as an opportunity to be working in a fully integrated, fully functional facility with mentorships by not just the faculty, but also by engineers and scientists and our corporate partners. I think this provides a much richer research environment than many other types of lab facilities across the country.
I made this machine because we needed a custom piece of equipment that could process this nanocomposite plastic. A lot of the commercial off-the-shelf machines didn't actually allow for plating and printing. So with this equipment where we can do two different materials at once, we can print this electrically conductive polymer with a non-conductive polymer.
When I started my graduate studies, the project was so interesting, successful, and rewarding that I stayed until I finished my PhD program.
I went directly into my research as soon as I graduated with my bachelor's degree and went into my master's degree because I knew that was the path I wanted to move forward with this research group.
What I liked the most about this place were great professors, good students, great facility, lots of equipment, and research that were funded by big companies interested in cutting-edge research.
Our students interact with people of all different disciplines every day. We've had over 100 companies visit us in the last year and a half, and our students interact with all of those companies.
I've had the opportunity to work with many distinguished people in industry, most notably Creative Materials, Raytheon, Rogers, and all of those companies have worked with us here at Rory and Perk to develop our prototypes.
One of the benefits to meeting all of these different companies is networking. I mean, it could help you get a job in the future for sure. This is a great place to be and gives you a lot of good opportunities.
Working here allowed me to meet a lot of people from different companies, and one of those companies offered me a job once I finished my program.
We're very excited about what we've set up here. We're now a fully capable facility, well thought of, good reputation in the field. We are going to be working on advancing this technology. I believe we will have an impact on the future of electronics in form factors that are different from where we are today. There'll be electronics embedded in medical devices, cell phone technology, so-called 5G. Cell phones are going to require 30 gigahertz operation built into a small form factor. That's where we excel. So we're excited about our ability to impact the electronics industry and provide a different means for people to interact with electronics in a way that we don't currently.